Tom.
Lord, as Joe, you used the expression jaw-dropping. That about sums it up. In any federal courtroom, that is what it would be. A once promising grad student at the U of I accused of kidnapping, rape, and murder, and his own lawyer tells the court it's true.
The family of Yingying Zhang, here from China, arriving at the federal courthouse, where lawyers for her accused killer are about to deliver a bombshell. In his opening statement, attorney George Tassif stepped before the jury and calmly said Brendt Christensen is responsible for the death of Yingying Zhang. Repeating himself, Brendt Christensen killed Yingying Zhang, and nothing we say or do during this phase of the trial is intended to sidestep or deny that Brendt Christensen is responsible for the death of Yingying Zhang. That shocking pronouncement came after the feds spent a chilling 45 minutes outlining their case. While the 26-year-old's body has never been found, the evidence against the 29-year-old Christensen is staggering. Police say Zhang's blood covered his bedroom with a DNA match. Surveillance video shows her getting into his black Saturn on the U of I campus on June 9, 2017. And then there are his own words, recorded on a wire worn by his then-girlfriend. The feds say he admits abducting, raping, and killing the visiting Chinese scholar, cutting off her head in his bathtub. Prosecutor Eugene Miller summing it up this way. He kidnapped her. He killed her. He covered it up. And astonishingly, they say, there's more. A claim of 12 other abductions and murders. Christensen boasting on tape of being a prolific serial killer. His lawyer calls it meaningless, drunken rambling, claiming his client struggled with alcohol and drugs, and that when he sought counseling at the U of I for urges to harm himself and others, he was turned away. At one point, the accused killer appeared to be in tears. Dr. Kim T is here from Chicago to support the Zhang family.
Before the case happened, everyone thought the America is a safe place, but since this happened, it's not anymore. So everyone in the hometown, including my hometown, they think it's very dangerous to even walk on the street of in America.
Today's surprise admission of guilt, likely a bid to save Brendt Christensen's life. While the state of Illinois did away with capital punishment back in 2011, this is a federal case, and prosecutors indicated early on they planned to seek the death penalty. Live at the federal courthouse in Peoria, Tom Negeman, WGN News.